currently fifth. Okay, their best lap time so far is a 1 minute.
We're here in the coastal shores of Florida for the Miami Grand Prix, which has become the 11th Formula One track held in the United States. The grandstands are packed for what we hope is going to be another fantastic race. A lap of the Miami Grand Prix features 3.36 miles of track around the Hard Rock Stadium, and 19 corners make up the Miami International Autodrome, which will challenge the drivers in a tight wheel-to-wheel race. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Oscar Piastri lines up on pole position, edging out Lando Norris, who'll start from P2. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Verstappen, Perez, Carlos Sainz, and Russell, Leclerc, Moore, Ocon, and Pierre Gasly, Bottas, Mick Schumacher, Yuki Tsunoda and Joe, Albon, Schwartzman, Lance Stroll and Nicholas Latifi. Vettel and Kevin Magnussen fills the last spot on the grid. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
I know this is your home Grand Prix, but treat it like any other race. Let's not make any unnecessary... Okay, incredible parking there. Nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get a good launch as the race starts. Okay, so that's the rest of the grid forming up. We'll be right back. Caution, the virtual safety car has just been deployed due to build-up of debris on the track. Delta until the green flags. Battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Ahead and in the DRS zone. Okay, George is coming in for his stop. Perfect job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. George is in the pits, he's in the pits now. looking to catch the car in front, but we need to look after the tyres. We won't be making another pit stop.
That's it for another Grand Prix and a fantastic win for Mercedes. Talk to me, Ants. What was it that set them apart from the competition today? And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners. Driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to Moore. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team to move themselves further up the table. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.
How do you want us to deal with this one? Thanks. I appreciate you taking the time to help out.